Okay, so for the record, present in the room, we have Director Bryce Walker, Director Gray, President Bradley, and on the phone, we have Director Walterman. Hearing number 8165, this hearing number 8165 is being conducted pursuant to Chapter 9 of Section 25.32.510 of the Revised Code of the City of St. Louis. Procedural history. February 27, 2014. Applicant Sharon Patterson submitted an application for a permit to operate a 24-hour daycare facility at 3739 Page. March 14, 2014, a fire safety inspection certificate is issued to Playtime Academy Daycare and Learning Center for 3739 Page Boulevard in consideration of the above referenced building and or occupant as duly inspected and is in compliance with the current City of St. Louis codes and ordinances at this time. June 20th, 2014. Zoning inspector submitted a memo stating that upon review of the flat petition, the petition was found to be in due form. However, two churches known as Mustard Seed House of Prayer at 3803 Page and Union Sinai MB Church at 3706 Cousins Avenue are within the prescribed radius of the proposed facility. Therefore, a recommendation was made to deny applicant's permit per Section 903.1 of Section 25.32.510 of the Revised Code of the City of St. Louis, which reads in part, no such application shall be approved wherein a church, elementary school, or secondary school is located within the prescribed radius. July 21st, 2014, letter sent from the Health Department to DPS saying that no evidence of health code violations was found at the facility at 3739 Page. The Health Department therefore recommended approval of a DPS permit. August 19th, 2014, the Board of Public Service met to review the recommendation of the zoning inspector. The board voted to uphold the recommendation to deny the applicant a permit to operate a 24-hour daycare facility. The applicant was advised of appeal rights in a letter dated the same day. The applicant then filed an appeal form advising the board of their request for an appeal hearing. On October 21st, 2014, letters sent to applicant notifying them of today's hearing. November 13, 2014, letters sent to the applicant notifying them of the room change for today's hearing. As outlined in Section 903.5.1 of Section 25.32.510 of the Revised Code of the City of St. Louis, after considering the evidence and argument, if any, submitted in support of the applicant, the board may issue the permit or confirm the action of denial in refusing to do so. The Board of Public Service has in its possession the following documents which are being introduced into evidence. A certified copy of Section 25.32.510 of the Revised Code of the City of St. Louis. Item 2, the applicant's file with the Office of the Secretary of Board of Public Service and the Office of the Zoning Administrator, which includes but is not limited to the following. A, the above-mentioned application, letters, memo, certificate, appeal form, and plat and petition of consent. B, copies of the public notice for today's hearing. C, a certificate of occupancy and zoning for 3739 Page for use as a 24-hour daycare center issued on October 31st, 2014. The board will swear in and hear from the representative of the City of St. Louis. Then the board will hear from the applicant and those in support of the applicant. The board will then allow those in opposition of the appeal, if any, to address the board. Testimony is being recorded. When you come forward, please state your name and address and be sworn in. As you testify, please direct your comments to the board, not to those in the audience. Members of the audience are asked to remain silent and not coach the person at the podium. After your testimony, members of the board may have questions for you. Following this hearing, the board will proceed with its scheduled agenda. On the conclusion of the regular agenda, the board will deliberate, discuss, and vote on hearing number 8165. The board will notify the applicant of their decision in writing, by mail, in about 2 weeks. board asked the representatives of the city please come forward to testify to the accuracy of the information stated above. And that is the city representative from the Department of Health. Is anyone present from the Department of Health? Seeing none. City representative from the Division of Building Inspection and Zoning Section.
Would you raise your right hand, please? Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God?
My name is Myra Turner. I'm zoning inspector for the city of St. Louis.
Did you review the completed plat and neighborhood consent petition submitted by the applicant?
Yes, I did. And also, I wanted a correction to be noted. The date of my memo is June 20th, 2013, not 2014. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Okay. Please tell the board about your review of the plat and consent petition.
Ms. Patterson turned in her plat petition. I found everything to be the way that it should be. However, in going out to survey the area, there were two churches in the area. Again, as stated, it was Union Sinai and I got them right here in front of me. Union Sinai and Mustard Seed House of Prayer. So, because of the ordinance, I had to deny that plat petition, not because of the signatures. She had enough signatures, and they were verified, but because of the churches in the area that had to be verified.
Do we have any indication that either of those two churches have any issue with this permit?
No.
Does the board have any other questions? Seeing none, thank you very much. Is there a city representative present from fire safety? Or is that, okay. The applicant, please be sworn in.
Could you raise your right hand, please? Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God?
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about the proposed daycare facility that you're going to operate?
Well, the daycare I originally started working on probably in May of 2013. I knew that it was going to be a long process with the 24 hours, so that was one of the steps that I began first. And I just felt like a 24-hour process of daycare will benefit the area that I'm in because I know parents have extended hours. And I just think it would be a great outcome having extended hours legally to run daycare.
Okay. How many rooms will the daycare occupy?
One room, two areas.
Okay. Total number of children permitted at the facility?
46.
And do you have daycare license in the city of St. Louis?
I am licensed.
And how many employees?
We probably have about 10 to 12 employees now.
Okay. Are you aware of any issues that either of the two churches that were mentioned may have with your facility?
They actually donate books and toys to us.
Okay. Any other questions from the board?
So you're existing, you're just wanting to go 24 hours?
Yes.
What are the care hours then?
6 a.m. to 9 p.m. Monday through 7 days of the day.
Any other questions from the board? Okay, thank you very much. Is there anyone here in favor of the proposed establishment that wishes to testify? If so, please be sworn in.
Could you raise your right hand, please? Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help you God?
Yes, I do.
State your name for the board, please.
Michael Patterson.
Can you tell us why you're in support of this?
Yes, to piggyback off of Sharon, I believe that that a lot of the customers at the Playtime Academy, the parents work unconventional hours, and there is not enough daycares to service the market. And I believe that it would be a good service to allow the 24-hour to be permitted. Also, there's some research that suggests that having kids in a quality daycare environment, that they will go further in education. They will have larger earning potentials in life. So that's a good attribute.
Okay. All right. Does the board have any questions? Thank you very much.
Okay.
Hey, is there anyone in opposition to the proposed establishment? I feel free to step forward at this time. Okay. Seeing none. The matter concerning hearing number 8165 is now closed and submitted. The board will deliberate the matter following the remaining agenda.
Director Scarby is excused. Director Waterman?
Waterman?
Aye. Director Bess is excused. Director Sidoff is excused. Director Rice Walker?
Aye.
Director Gray?
Aye.
And President Bradley?
Aye. We have a quorum. We'll go ahead and call meeting in order.
From the President, plans and specifications for letting number 8565 Kings Highway Bridge reconstruction over Union Pacific Railroad. Preliminary approval for letting number 8558 Carondelet Park ADA upgrade to comfort station. Maintenance agreement between Metropolitan St. Louis Sewer District and the City of St. Louis for the issuance of a sewer permit by MSD for stormwater management facilities for Oakland, Skinker to Hampton, Oakland Street improvements. I'm the Director of Public Utilities and Streets. Joint recommendation that the following permits be approved subject to certain conditions as follows. Laclede Gas Company to install an ammeter light pole on light pole for water feature control at 700 Market, and Union Electric Company doing business in Ameren, Missouri to install 40 feet pole on the west side of Compton, south of I-44, Compton Bridge replacement. From the Director of Public Utilities and Public Safety, joint recommendation that permit for JRS St. Louis to consolidate land at 3536 and 3540 Washington and City Block 1060 recommends approval subject to certain conditions. From the Director of Streets, recommendation that permit for S&P Properties Glider House to encroach with panel and gate at 2254 Judith Court be denied. The encroachment will result in the street being closed on both ends, limiting public access on city maintained public right-of-way. From the Director of Public Safety, we have the conditional uses.
Good afternoon, Mr. President, members of the board. I'm Bob Lordy. I'm zoning plan examiner for the city, and I'll be representing the building commissioner at today's meeting. Per board order number 766, transmitted herewith our recommendations for the following conditional use agenda applications. Approval is recommended for one application at 5528 Botanical. Approval with conditions is recommended for four applications, 1631 McLaren, 4120 Upton, 910 Rutger, and 2207 through 11 South 12th Street. I request that these recommendations be approved as submitted.
Tim, any questions from the board? Seeing none, I'll take a motion, please.
So moved. I move to approve.
Second. Okay, then motion to approve. And second, can you read the roll, please?
Director Scobie is excused. Director Waterman.
Aye.
Director Bess is excused. Director Sidoff is excused. Director Rice Walker?
Aye.
Director Gray?
Aye.
And President Bradley?
Aye. Approved. Okay. Motion, we have a couple of items that are tabled. You assume you don't have any action on either of those today. Is that correct? No action? All right. Seeing none, we need to hearing number 8165.
Okay.
I have a motion to approve.
Second time.
Okay, is there any discussion? Okay, seeing none, can you call the roll, please?
Director Scalby is excused. Director Waterman?
Aye.
Director Bess is excused. Director Sidoff is excused. Director Rice Walker?
Aye.
Director Gray?
Aye.
And President Bradley?
Aye. Approved. Motion to accept the agenda, please.
Addendum.
So moved.
Yeah.
Do you have an addendum?
Yes.
Okay, I understand. Motion to accept, we gotta go back here. We need a motion to accept the addendum for you.
So moved.
Okay, second. Okay, motion seconded to accept the addendum. Excuse me, can you call the roll, please?
Director Scobie is excused. Director Waterman?
Aye.
Director Biss is excused. Director Seedoff is excused. Director Rice Walker?
Aye.
Director Gray?
Aye.
And President Braley?
Aye. Approved. Motion to accept the agenda, please.
So moved.
Second.
Second. Previous roll.
Okay, so motion is seconded to accept the agenda. Call for use of previous roll. Is there any objection to use previous roll? Seeing none. Approved. Motion to adjourn, please.
So moved.
I'm sorry.
All in favor?
So what's
up? Anybody vote?